Championship up for grabs. The reigning title holder, the Ultimate Warrior, to square off against the former champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
Well, Honky's had time to prepare this time, and I think the results are going to be vastly different against the Ultimate Maniac.
And what about the main event, the Hulkster, to meet the 500-pound Akeem?
You know, 1988's been a great year for me. I saw Hogan take the beating of his life at the hands of the Big Boss Man, and I think the rest of Slick's army, Big Akeem, is going to do in Hogan. He's ripe for the picking.
And what about our special haircut matchup, as we will see Outlaw Ron Bass square off against Brutus the Barber Beefcake? And Jesse, you know a little something about losing hair.
Hey, don't talk to me about that. The only baldy around here is that little bald maniac, Mean Gene, that midget.
I think he's standing by.
Ron Bass, you're up against the man who's on a mission, Brutus the Barber Beefcake. After what you did to him with those spurs and the...
You mean the Mavic brothers, Brett and Bart?
And that whip.
Yeah, Miss Betsy. You mean good old Miss Betsy.
Okay, why did you agree, Ron Bass, to a haircut match of all things? Remember what Brutus the Barber Beefcake did to your hat?
Well, I'm busy letting the Maverick brothers, Brad and Bart, tenderize that meathead. And you know, they love to dance, especially when Miss Betsy, she's calling the tone.
All right, for a man whose head, or at least his hair, is on the chopping block, I can't believe it, a very confident Outlaw Ron Bass heads into the ring for this one tonight.
Well, the rivalry comes to a head, Jesse, no pun intended, right here in Tampa tonight. And what a rivalry it has been. Outlaw Ron Bass, mean, nasty, against Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Well, I'll tell you what, it was Beefcake that started all of this, McMahon, not the Outlaw Ron Bass. It was Brutus Beefcake stepping in and interfering in a match that the Outlaw had, and he started it all, McMahon.
I'm not so sure about that, Jesse, but nonetheless, Brutus the Barber certainly has his opportunity to prove that he's a better man tonight, not only by winning the matchup, but by doing a little cutting and a little strutting, a little bit off the top, maybe off the side.
Now, you're presuming Beefcake's going to win. He's got to pin that man to cut anybody's hair.
Well, you can take a look at this flashback here. You will recall it was the Outlaw Ron Bass going to work for his opponent, and the Barber could not take any more of it. Yes, indeed, he interfered, justifiably so, to take matters into his own hands.
And look what he does there, snapping and cutting Miss Betsy into pieces. And if that's not bad enough, there he goes after the Outlaw's Texas hat. You don't do that to a Texan.
Yes, but in true bushwhacker fashion, it was not long after this that Brutus the Barber had his back turned to the Outlaw.
And justifiably so, as you like to say, McMahon. One good turn deserves another, and it's payback time for Brutus the Barber at the hands of Brett and Bart right here.
Well, someone will be paying some dues tonight, no question of that, and it could very well be Brutus the Barber once again, or then again, it could be Outlaw Ron Bass humiliated publicly with his hair shaved by the Barber. Let's take you now to Mean Gene.
All right, that is some very gruesome footage that we have just eyewitnessed, Brutus the Barber Beefcake. How can you forget the horror that you experienced that night when you face Outlaw Ron Bass in tonight's haircut match?
I don't want to forget. I want to remember it all. I want to remember it when I'm cutting all his hair off. And I want him to remember the face of the Barber.
All right, Brutus Beefcake, none of this is going to bring back that title shot that Outlaw Ron Bass cost you. What is it with this haircut match? Is it a matter of revenge?
A matter of revenge? It's a matter of hair. And if you had any, you'd know what matters.
All right, Vince, Brutus the Barber has a strange obsession that I can't quite explain. Can Outlaw Ron Bass handle it? We'll find out tonight in the ring. Back to you.
All right, and we are anxiously anticipating this matchup. Brutus the Barber squaring off against Outlaw Ron Bass, and the Barber is just now making his entrance into the arena.
Well, this should be a great matchup, McMahon. You know, this rivalry goes back quite a number of weeks now. These two do not like each other, and we're going to see the final confrontation right here tonight.
Indeed, and the loser, not only losing the matchup, but will be publicly humiliated by losing his hair. The Barber was certainly up for lookout. Wait a minute. Outlaw Ron Bass hammering away. A sneak attack.
Bass has wasted no time, and he's got Miss Betsy around Brutus's throat. He's choking him up. This could be a very fast ending, McMahon.
Come on, ref, get in there. This is not a no-holds-barred matchup. Beefcake trying to escape and finally does.
Whoa, and Beefcake
Beefcake's got Betsy now.
It certainly does. Wait a minute. All right. Maybe the Outlaw's going to get a whooping here.
Now, how come you're not yelling for the referee to step in now?
The referee should step in there, but I think he's a little bit intimidated.
Certainly he is. I wouldn't want to get hit with Miss Betsy, even if it is by Brutus, and he probably don't know how to snap a whip too well.
I don't know about that. Brutus the Barber, ready for action. And apparently the Outlaw, Ron Bass, a little reticent about jumping back into the ring.
Well, you can't blame the Outlaw. Not until Rivera Morella finally got the whip away. Now we'll get the action underway. We'll get down to what it should be. Wrestling.
I'm most anxious to find out who loses this matchup and loses their hair, but I think I'm a little bit more concerned, Jesse, with whether or not we're going to see Bart and Brat. The Maverick brothers, I think he called them, the Spurs.
Well, I'll tell you what, if the Outlaw gets the chance, you can bet that Bart and Brat will be introduced to Mr. Beefcake again.
High knee by the Barber, and the Outlaw is on the outside of the ring. Right back up, however. Brutus connects, and down goes the Outlaw again. A most determined, mean, nasty Outlaw, Ron Bass, back up on the apron, and Beefcake won't let him in the ring.
Well, Beefcake's being smart. He's keeping the Outlaw out on the floor. Woo. That way, it's to Beefcake's advantage throughout the match. If the Outlaw can't get into the ring, he certainly can't pin Beefcake.
There's the strutting, and yes, maybe later on, we're going to see a little cutting from the Barber.
Well, we're going to see cutting, all right, but it might be that man right there doing the strutting and the cutting before it's over.
Outlaw, Ron Bass, with an advantage as far as weight and overall size is concerned.
You know, McMahon, one thing interesting, I wonder how Brutus would look with a bald head. You know, he's so proud in his hair and takes such time with it. You know, I think he'd look like Mean Gene Okerlund's illegitimate son when this is over.
Really? I'm not too sure about that, but right now, Beefcake hammering away on the Outlaw. Brutus the Barber with momentum, and down goes the Outlaw.
Well, you can tell that this match is already turning into a fight.
Beefcake off the rope again. Look out! Brutus the Barber is just all over Outlaw Ron Bass. He wants this match. The cover! Get over there, Ruff!
He's not covering anybody.
The shoulders are down.
There's Bret and Bart sitting in the corner waiting. And look at Beefcake hammering away at the Outlaw. This is ridiculous. Why didn't Morella step in there? Those are close fists, McMahon. About 15 of them. I can't even believe these people can count that high.
Well, I think maybe the referee is allowing a little extra latitude here as far as the bending of the rules are concerned.
And why should he do that?